Hey, church family. The last couple of days, I've read from a couple of the Psalms, just encouraging you with some encouraging words from God's Word about suffering, about difficulty, about how God is close to the brokenhearted. And the place I want to go today is actually near the end of the Bible in Revelation chapter 21. I read part of this passage in the sermon this past Sunday, but I just want to read it and then make a couple of comments and just keep your eyes focused where they ought to be right now. Revelation chapter 21 says, "Then I saw the new heaven and the new earth, for the first heaven and the first earth had passed away, and the sea was no more. And I saw the holy city, New Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. And I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, 'Behold, the dwelling place of God is with man. He will dwell with them, and they will be his people, and God himself will be with them as their God. And he will wipe away every tear from their eyes, and death shall be no more. Neither shall there be mourning, nor crying, nor pain any more, for the former things have passed away.'" I want to draw your attention to sort of the beginning and the end of the story, okay? So there's all kinds of stuff we can talk about there, and I'm super interested in it, and I think it's incredible. But I want to focus on one small detail that maybe you didn't notice. It says, "He will wipe away every tear from their eyes." He will wipe away every tear from their eyes. Notice that, like, it says that there's not going to be any more mourning or crying or pain, but when God's dwelling place is with his people, it doesn't say that their tears will dry up. It doesn't say just say that there won't be any more tears, though it does say that. It actually says that he will wipe away every tear. There's this really cool thing at the beginning of the story, and that is when God creates the universe. And think about, like, the sun and moon and stars are way cooler than me. Okay, like, you could, if anybody who's going to write, like, a story about my life, it would not be as interesting as people who know the inner workings of stars and suns and how the universe, like, how these gases come together to make this beautiful thing, and how many billions of years, light years they are away, and how many of them there are. Like, it's incredible to me. And yet, when God spoke the sun and moon and stars into existence, he spoke them. He said a word and they appeared. When God created the animals, he spoke a word and they appeared. When God created the sea and separated the land, he spoke and it happened. But how is it that God created man? You remember? Remember the story? It actually says that he put his hands in the dirt and he formed man. So all of creation is created by the spoken word of God, that God's words are so powerful that they create, they call into being that which is not. So he could have spoke Adam into existence, but instead it says he gathered up the dirt, which implies, does that not imply like a stooping down, right? That he went and had to scoop the earth, put his hands into the soil, and out of the dirt form, it says he formed man, and then he breathed life into him. So just like he created all the animals and birds and fish and suns and moons and stars, he could have spoken, but instead he chose to personally use his hands and form man and breathe life into him. That's how God chose to create man. And then at the end of the story, when our dwelling place is back with God, when the separation is no longer there, when sin is finally defeated and eradicated and God's holy presence is with his people, it says that he will wipe away our tears. Again, using his hands to complete the job, right? That he sent his son and his son died and he called us into being and he sent the Spirit that regenerates our hearts and puts life into us, causes us to obey his commands, all those things. But then when he comes down, he uses his hands personally to wipe away the tears. And what I want you to grasp from that is just how important you are, okay? Not important like, I don't want you to get an inflated ego or anything, but what I want you to recognize is that mankind is the pinnacle of God's creation, and his covenant people he cares so deeply about that the creator of the universe, who can speak anything and have it happen, chooses to personally involve himself and his hands in their creation and personally involve himself and his hands in the final wiping away of their tears. How incredible is that? How precious are you to God? You know, the book of Zephaniah, it's chapter 3, verse 17, it has this amazing verse where it says that God delights in us and sings over us. That he delights over his people with singing. That when we belong to him, in the same way that a father or a mother delights in their children, Colleen and I often joke about how we love watching Harper eat. So the other day we were eating corn on the cob, and you can imagine how messy this is, right? She's 1 year old and she's got this corn on the cob and she's just trying to figure out which end to bite and what the good parts are and everything. She's sitting there eating and like, she's messy and it's quite gross. Like if it was anybody else's kid, I think it was gross, but it's my kid. I think it's adorable and it's precious and it's incredible. And that's the sort of affection that God has when he looks at us. And that's why he's not content to come down and see to it that there are no more tears. He comes down to personally use his hands and wipe away the tears from our eyes. I think that's incredible. And so whatever else is going on in your life, however life is not going your way, know that you serve and belong to a personal God who formed you with his own hands and will wipe away your tears with his very hands because he cares deeply about you. Hope you find that encouraging. May the Lord be with you.